you combine a strong cis with a strong trans and the three seem to elevate to get strong expression. So the reason why that happens is because the divergent regulators are being brought together in a way that we infer some means that some C. elegans factor is recognizing the motif in C. Briggs' sequence and then activating expression in these two cells where it should be activated. So of course we ask, what are the divergent cis and trans regulators that are causing this misexpression? So we figured that a transcription factor that would have this function would be expressed in the STQ cells, and it would also be expressed in some subset of the neurons that usually express 147, that endogenously express the gene. There is only one transcription factor protein that fit that description, and it's called AHR1. And then we crossed a C-Briggs-E promoter GFP-containing strain into the mutant strain. We see that expression in STQR and STQL is completely abolished. So this makes us pretty confident that AHR1 is the transcription factor responsible for this ectopic expression. Fortunately for us, AHR1 has a known binding motif. And this binding motif is present in the proximal promoter. So when we take the C. Briggs-E M47 promoter and we express it in C. elegans, once again you see very strong expression in the STQ cells. And this is the cell DBB that's part of the endogenous pattern that also expresses. But when you knock out this particular binding site, you lose expression. So when you knock out the transcription factor, you lose expression in these cells. And when you knock out the binding site, you lose expression in these cells. And while you don't lose expression in DBB, the intensity of expression falls by about 100-fold. So it seems like this binding site is involved with regulating expression in DBB, which is part of the endogenous expression pattern. But as a byproduct, it can activate expression in the STQ cells. When you combine the C-Briggs-E regulatory sequence with the C. elegans transcription factor environment. But here's the thing that really confused us. The binding site is completely conserved between Briggs-E, Benerow, and RNAi elegans. It's boxed in here, CACGC. So we next looked to nearby sequences that might differ among C-Briggs-E and the other species. And we have this region here that we call region A. It contained a good amount of divergence among these species. And so what we want to ask is, are the sequences from elegans and Briggs-E functionally equivalent, or are they different? And the way we're going to test them is by switching them back and forth. So we're going to take a Briggs-E promoter, and we're going to put that little region A of C. elegans into the middle of it. And then we're going to do the opposite experiment. Take an elegans promoter and put a tiny piece of Briggs-E in the middle of that. And we're going to ask if they are functionally equivalent or if they do something different when they're swapped. So as it turns out, sequences in the C. Briggs-E region A and interactions with outside sequences are sufficient for expression in the STQ cells. So here we have the percentage of worms expressing in the cell STQR and STQL. And we have elegans over here, Briggs-E over here, and then the two chimeras in between. And we see whether you have a Briggs-E region A or Briggs-E outside of region A, you express just as strongly as C. Briggs-E. So it seems like there are at least two elements that are each sufficient for expression, one within and one without this region A. On the other hand, in STQL, Briggs-E expresses strongly, elegans expresses very weakly, and both of the chimeras express very weakly as well. And so this suggests to us that there's an epistatic interaction between something in Briggs-E region A and something outside of it.